played for the Harlem Globetrotters. They play this song as they come out. And sometimes I get to sit on the bench and they. Actually, my nickname was Little Mac. My dad was Big Mac. He was bigger than me. I was about this high when I started going to the dance. So we're going to open up with Sweet Georgia Brown. It features a lot of people. This is the Battleground High School Advanced Jazz Band. We've been working really hard. Looking forward to this performance.
Glad to be here.
late, great Dizzy Gillespie, great trumpet player. I actually had a chance to see him perform right before he died. This is called Ubop Shabam. Can you say Ubop Shabam? That's our way of speaking in tongues. Features Caleb Armstrong on trombone and vocals.
Caleb! Yo, baby!
You remember him?
Yeah, he was in my Sunday school class.
Oh, he's in your Sunday school class.
Thank you. tune that we're going to do features our vocals. How many of you, I know Dr. Phillips knows who I'm talking about because she probably might have lived in that era. I love you. Anyway, this was written by the late, great singer, Billie Holiday.
I know.
We have a gal that we think does a very good imitation of Billie Holiday. She doesn't look like her, but that's okay. But anyway, this is going to feature Breonna Sievers on a tune called God Bless the Child.
Thank you.
because he actually came out to Battleground High School. People do come out to Battleground sometimes. Important people, okay? And black people, okay? But he came out to Battleground, and since he wrote this tune, he spent 2 hours working with me on it. And what we found out is, even though we were playing it really well, he wanted us to depict big bacon grease. And that's not very charming, a bucket of bacon grease. And so, in other words, he wanted us to put some stank on it and get really nasty. And so that's what we did. It's called Grease Bucket. Hope you like it. It features Caleb Armstrong on trombone, Matt Warming on trombone, Ryan Russell on tenor saxophone, Tyler Moore on alto saxophone, David Heinrichsen on piano, and Ezra, he's not a girl, he's a guy, on bass. He gets mistaken for a girl all the time. I told him he needs to grow some facial hair or something. Grease Bucket. We'll be right back. next tune, one of the things I like about being the band director is I get to pick tunes that I like. And when I was growing up, I grew up with the Motown sound, and I used to love to listen to little Stevie Wonder. And this tune that we're going to do, next month, I'm actually going down to my old high school in Richmond, California. We're celebrating our 40th reunion. I know I don't look like I'm that old, but I am. But anyway, this tune was written by Stevie Wonder, and it depicts some of the things that Stevie used to do, looking back on when I was a little nappy-headed boy, some of the things that he used to do. I used to do them too. Smoking cigarettes, writing something nasty on the wall. I have changed. I don't do that anymore. But I used to. So anyway, this tune was written by Stevie Wonder, and it's called I Wish. By the way, let's give Matt Warren stand up a hand for good job. Good job. Yeah, the guy blew his heart out. Good job, Matt. Thank you. then is everything okay? Everything okay? Good. So, give me some feedback. The next tune we're going to do was written by probably one of my favorite composers, Duke Ellington. And some of you don't know this, but back in 2006, the Battleground Band from Battleground High School, we auditioned for the Century Ellington Festival. There were 97 bands that competed that audition. We were one of 15 that were chosen in the nation, so we got to spend time in New York. You know what? It's funny how, if I can preach a little bit, the devil didn't want us to win because we got up in the air heading to New York and our plane had to come back because an emergency chute rolled out in midair. We had to come back. We got to New York. When we got to New York, we had to play the next day and our instruments and our music wasn't there. So to make a long story short, we begged and pleaded to get those uniforms, get those instruments in our uniforms there. We got there with a few hours to spare, and lo and behold, the band came in second in the nation. And the good thing is that we were so worried about our luggage and our instruments, we didn't have time to get nervous. So that was a blessing in disguise. In fact, the irony is that they had already chosen the three bands that they thought were going to win, and they came out and filmed them and did this big DVD on them, and didn't even think that back in Battleground, we were working our tails off. And so we came in second. We lost first place by 3 points, and that was among 5 judges. So and I think we probably should have come in first, but they had the same face. So we got second. But anyway, this next tune, written by Duke Ellington, it was actually recorded by Count Basie. It's called In a Mellow Tone. It features Matt Warming on trombone. Are you okay, Matt? Okay. You know, thank you in a mellow tone. This next tune, I have David Greenidge is actually responsible for this tune. I put together an all-star band. We were playing at Irvington Covenant, and David said, you know, all this jazz stuff is good, but do you have anything gospel type? And I thought of this tune that I arranged. It's an Andre Crouch tune called Bless His Holy Name. I actually arranged it when I was 21 years old. At the age of 21, you don't really know anything. You think you do. So I never passed it out, and it sat in my files for over 30 years. And so David suggested that I do a gospel tune, type tune. I thought of this tune that I had arranged back when I was 21, but I didn't want to pass it out because I thought it would sound really bad. Because like I said, at 21, you don't really, you think you know stuff, but you really don't. And one of these days, I'm going to actually take this tune and kind of tweak it, knowing what I know now, after 30-some years. But anyway, this is tune's called Bless His Holy Name, written by Andre Crouch. I hope you like it. It features our lead trumpet player, Joel Riddell. Give him a hand. And also Tyler Moore. He's actually playing the part that I wrote for myself, but I'll let him play. Okay. Bless His Holy Name. Psalm 103. Connie yet. But anyway, we're going to do one more tune. This feature is Tyler Moore on alto. And it features our drummer. Now this drummer actually reminds me, is Nehemiah around? Where's Nehemiah? Okay. Anyway, this guy, I've known this guy since he was in the sixth grade, and I probably yell at him more than anybody. But the bottom line is, I knew he had a lot of potential, just like Nehemiah. And he's got, and he always took it. He never yelled back. But sometimes I've been ruthless to him. But the bottom line is, he's turned into a really, really good drummer. We're going to feature him on our last tune. It's called Conservation. Again, we hope you've enjoyed it. I really put a lot of work into this, because when this is over, I still have to come to church on Sunday. Okay, all the other competitions, I don't see those people, but I have to come every Sunday, so it's important that this stuff be right. And thanks to the band, we're actually on summer vacation. Actually got a few more performances. And actually, if anybody out there has a performance for us, please let me know. We're going to keep the band together. We just recorded our second CD since I've been at Battleground, and it turned out really good. It should be out in the fall. So, the good thing, and you know, this group, if I can brag about them, last year, we started out, we opened up and did a concert with Esperanza Spalding. That turned out really good. And then from there on, the band, I didn't think we would be as good as we were, because we had seven new freshmen. But they did really well, placed in every competition. The last one, we just killed everybody. I mean, just killed everybody, including some of our people that normally beat us. We beat them really bad, and I loved it. But anyway, we're going to end with a tune called Conservation. Yeah, Nehemiah, I want you to listen to this cat. Check this cat out. This is how you're going to be one of these days. You just got to let me yell at you a few times, okay? Okay, is that a deal? Because his time is just like yours sometimes. So we're going to work on it, okay? But listen to this cat. Okay, Conservation. We'll be right back. We're going to be in church on Sunday, so you get to hear us on Sunday. So,
all right.
Thank you, and may God bless you.
Good evening, everyone. Are you having a good time tonight?
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right. I'm not going to be up here telling jokes, but that's what you might have gotten from the introduction. Yeah. I see Caleb's mom. How are you doing? Bring up my youth group. Would you please come up and join me? One of the things that we've been very, very fortunate to be doing is really, really, really kind of enjoying each other, as you can probably tell. And this has probably been the best opportunity that I could have had to be around a group of great, great, great young people. Basically, what we have begun doing is we started this month on our new, we call it a motto, but it's more like a mantra that we've adopted. This is the beginning of our year for our youth group, and our mantra this year is Life Matters. And basically, it is so that we can involve ourselves not only in the lives of each other, but within our church, within our community, within those things that we might be able to impact and gain some impact from. And so one of the things that I've asked my group to do, I've chosen four people to speak to you, and they're going to share with you just what the youth group means to them, and then I'll finish it up. So we're going to start on this end. Asked God is actually taking hold of her. God is moving her in a direction that he knows she's going to be safe. She's going to be secure. God has grabbed onto her, and guess what? When God grabs on you, he does not let go of you. Now, the young people that you see here today, this is just part of our group. And yes, we have a great time. We've learned how to enjoy each other. We've gone on mission trips, and we've seen what we have to offer, not just, each other, but our community. And that's what we want to share. And that's why we've adopted the motto for this year, Life Matters. And I know from being around them that they're gaining a very good understanding of the fact that life matters. I've watched them work with babies when we were on our mission trip, and how much that it hurt them to actually leave when they were actually involved with the parents and the children. I watched the young men when we were at Mary's house, which was a facility where we fed homeless mothers and their children. And some of these women, a lot of these women had babies. And it made me feel good when we were supposed to be there one day. They wanted to take another couple of days out of their trip to go back and do more of what they were there to do, to serve more, to be more. And it just made me feel real good. It made me feel good that they understand, they're getting it, whereas a lot of kids do not get it. And that I know because I'm around young people all the time, around them all the time. And I just appreciate them. And we're looking to grow. So if you have young people out there, middle school to high school, we're looking to grow. We're looking to add more. And I'll tell you, you cannot find a more loving group of people than this right here. So, thank you. And again, I will say, if you have young people, or if you know someone that have young people, please, please. We meet every Wednesday night, and that's at 7 o'clock right here, kind of coming to church, and we're getting ready to do more. So, expect to see us in the community. Thank you.
Down.
seated. Give the Lord a hand clap again. He's worthy to be praised. Everybody just look up in the sky. Look at that cloud configuration over there. When you consider the mighty God that we serve, every night he gives us a different scene of the clouds. There's no cloud that's ever the same. There's no scene every evening that's ever the same. Be you go out to the coast or you go to Mount Hood or Mount Rainier up north, any of the beautiful mountain peaks and the sceneries and the trees. I was up in Washington Park Zoo and I was looking over the Cascade of the hills and the greens, and I notice even as you look behind you and look at these trees, look at the various shades of green on all the trees and the bushes. And you consider a God that made that. And sometimes we as human beings focus instead of the Almighty God that made this beautiful scenery that's around us. We are getting focused on the wrong things. And I was there too. I was at a place in my life at one time. I was a young boy that grew up in the South Bronx of New York, and I found my eyes looking at all the things that were around me, and it allured me, and it kind of got my attention. I tried a little bit of this and a little bit of that, and as I got older, between the ages 11 and 12, I realized that even though I was out there with my buddies and we were playing basketball, we were having a good time, that there was a void in my heart, and I was an angry young man. And I realized that God eventually was the only one that could fill this void and deal with my anger problem. And mine was anger. Other people have other problems. No one person has the same issue in life. The Bible says that we are all tempted in one area or another, and we all have different weaknesses. And I just want to share with you about 5 minutes, the fact and the condition of our world today. And it grips my heart because I see people chasing and looking for love in all the wrong places. But there's a scripture in Matthew 6:33 which says, "Seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto you." When you and I take our eyes off of the earthly things and the things that lure us, and young people, the things that are pulling us away from what our parents are telling us and pulling us away from what God is telling us, when we do those things, we err and we end up in a ditch. And we end up in trouble. But if you and I tonight will just, for these last few minutes of the evening, and after I speak, Tim is going to close us out with a song. If we would just think about the Almighty God that made this beautiful scenery, this beautiful landscape across the sky, and realize that God is providing for every human being on the planet Earth. He provides food, and it's only that men and women in their heart that have gotten greedy, and the allocation of God's resources that they've hoarded it, or they've been greedy and they've made life miserable for other people. And I want us to focus on the fact that there's a need that all of us have, and that need that we have can only be filled by the Almighty God. Say amen. I know when I finally at age 12 said yes to the Lord, and I asked Jesus to come into my heart, and he came into my heart and changed me, that void in my heart was truly filled and my life was totally transformed. And you might be here tonight, you might have been in a place in your life where you have searched and where you have looked and you have pursued other things. You might have asked God to come into your life and have a relationship through his son Christ, and you might have done that and fallen away, or you might have never done that and you're pursuing all the options that you have in life, because life is about options. But as you tonight will think about the one main option, which is to seek first Jesus and his righteousness, the Bible says all these things will be added unto you. And ladies and gentlemen and young people, when I finally said yes to the Lord and he came in my heart and he dealt with my anger problem, he dealt with my hate problem, I found out that I could truly be the person that God wanted to be, God wanted me to be, and I could start loving people. Instead of the hate that was in my heart, I could be nice to people. I remember a pastor said up in Seattle, I used to listen to him all the time, he said, "It's nice to be nice." When you can be nice because niceness is coming out of your heart, when you can be kind to someone because something inside of you is pulling you in that direction, and you don't have to keep going in the ways of the flesh. How many know what the ways of the flesh? Just gotta nod your head. Because all of us have been there. We've done things where the flesh has pulled us, meaning that our inward desires that are not holy have pulled us into situations that have cost us and made us trip up and fall. And And so tonight, of all of us, be you a Christian or not, be you someone who's walking in the way or not, I want all of us to get to a place and whisper a prayer before I finish talking to the Almighty God, even while I'm speaking, and say, Lord, I want to be close to you. I want to seek you first. Because there's another scripture in Matthew 7 which says, ask and it shall be given unto you. When you and I ask, and then it says, knock and the door shall be opened unto you. When you get to that place where you are truly pursuing God, where you just say, oh, I know God on an intellectual level, and oh, he's cool. But when you get to the place where you just don't say, oh, I know him and I'll go to church once a month, or I'll go to church once, you know, every 2 months. But when you get to a place where you can say that you are seeking and pursuing God, then God has a relationship with you, and he loves you, and he calls you his own. And there's some benefits of you and I pursuing God. The scripture says, because he or she knows me when he's in trouble, because he know or she knows my name, when he or she is in trouble, I'm going to come to you in the time of your need, and I'm going to answer your prayer. How many tonight want their prayers answered? Amen. Every hand should go up. I know when I call on the Lord and I need help, I want my prayers answered. And God said he will come near to those who come near to him. God said he will be there for you when you get to the place where you seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and then all these things shall be added unto you. God demonstrates his love toward us in that while we were yet sinners, God said his son Christ died for us. Jesus died on a cross for you and I, so that you and I will be able to seek him with all of our hearts and not try to reach him by our own efforts, but that we would receive his love, he would call us his own, and we'll be there for him and he'll be there for us. So if you will ask Jesus to forgive you, and if you're a Christian, if you'll say, Lord, I'm letting go of everything and I want Christ to be first. If you'll do that tonight, you'll be in a new place, and every day, whether it's sunny or whether it's cloudy, whether the hail comes down or whether it's a hot sun, you'll be walking tall, because you know at any moment you can call on the Lord in any situation, be it good or bad, and God's going to be there for you. Would everybody bow your heads with me right now? This is a holy moment. Saints, pray. God is speaking to your heart. God is wooing you to himself. God wants you to have a relationship with him through his son, Jesus. And as every head is bowed and every eye is closed, as we just pause, as everyone stops walking, you might be in a place where you might have to confess and say, you know what, Pastor David, I need the Lord. I want him to come into my life. I need God to heal me. I need God to deal with me in the issues of my heart that are not right. And if you're in that place tonight where you want to be saved, the Bible says, Romans 10:9 says, if you will confess the Lord Jesus and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved. And if you're a Christian, if you will confess your sins, 1 John 9, he is faithful and just to forgive you of your sin and cleanse you from all unrighteousness. So for the first person, for the first group, who you've never said yes to the Lord and you want to be saved, just raise your hand right there where you are. Don't be ashamed. This is your day. You might be listening to me from the apartment complex. You might be listening from me from the car. You raise your hand right where you are. Say, I hear you, Pastor David. I had someone write me a letter last week saying, I heard the microphone 2 blocks away and I came down to see what was going on. So right now, just raise your hand and repeat this prayer after me. Dear God, I confess that I'm a sinner. I believe that you sent your son Jesus to die on the cross for me. And now, dear Jesus, forgive me of all my sin. Come into my heart. I turn away from my sin and I receive you as my Lord and Savior. And as heads are bowed, if you're a Christian and you're saying, Pastor, I want to give it up for the Lord. I want to give him everything. You raise your hand and I want to say a special prayer for you. Yes, I see that hand. Is there another? Yes, I see that hand. Is there another? Yes, I see that hand. Father God, we pray for those hands that are going up, those hands that are extended, that you would help them as they are your chosen vessels of honor, your children, that they're letting go of the past, and they're saying, I'm stepping into my destiny. I'm seeking first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and I receive his blessing in the name of Jesus. I bind the presence of the enemy, and I loose the power of the Holy Spirit in the life of every believer so that they can walk tall and be number one with you. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Tim, would you come? Mm-hmm.
deserves. But you've never turned your back on me. When I fall, then you came and set me on my feet again. Your forgiving heart is incredible, and I am grateful. That's why I love.
What?
We're going to remain standing because we're done for the night. Just to let you know that Tim is the leader of our Greenwich family, and Tim and the family are singing, doing a concert here the last Saturday night of this month, July the 28th. But next Friday night, which is July 20th, we're having two young bands from Tigard High School come, and we're having Alberta give a testimony, and we're going to have one other song, and then we are just going to have a good time that Friday night, and then the following Saturday night, then we'll conclude our month-long outdoor activity festival. Let's give the Lord a hand clap if you've been blessed tonight. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. And as Greg said earlier, the Battle High School Band will be performing at church here, Tigard Covenant Church, Sunday at 10 o'clock, and everybody's welcome to come. Would you grab your neighbor's hand as we dismiss him? Father God, we just thank you so much that you have blessed us tonight. As we get ready to go home tonight, would you take us home safely, Lord, and may the presence of the Almighty God abide in our hearts, and this blessing that has been bestowed on all of us by your Holy Spirit and by the uplifting of your Son, Jesus, may it go with us in the evening and tomorrow, and may we have a mind to praise you and to seek you above all others. We thank you, Jesus, and we ask for your blessing. In your name we pray, amen. Why don't you go shake somebody's hand and say, good night. Good night, man. Good night.